When we go now at the National Minerals Agency, USAI, the Director General, Sawunde, don't say that 40% government get forgive Pastor Momo out of this, but $6.5 million where then sell the 706 carat diamond way in Bifen Nakono. He say this couple, they now na the Sialon Commercial Bank, and they wait for my government engage with all of that involved before then go Shebam. Waninga Oja gets more and go now report.
The 709 carat diamond way Pastor Momo inside March 17 this year Bifen Nakono don't be of great concern to plenty people them as to how the government pass with this diamond. Where according to the Director General and National Mineral Agency Sawunde say they don't sell this diamond for $6.5 million. But say the rumor where they go around on social media say the government see for this couple not to true. As he say, the way how they end up selling this diamond, plenty people not understand. We make it be start for explain.
The highest bid submitted was 7,077,707. We, the experts, we advise them to accept it because our value in the NMA was 7 million. The independent expert that we use, that we contract and pay every month, they had a value of 5.8. Pastor Mama wanted and his group wanted 30 million. How could we sell it? You would be the same to have accused us of undervaluing the diamond if we had decided to accept 7 million on that day. So we decided that the reserve price, which was Pastor Momo's price, was not met. So we decided not to sell. So we decided to take it out for international tender. The auction house carried out a lot of publicity to attract a lot of people to bid for it. The person who submitted the bid for 707777 participated in the bid in New York. It's interesting to note that in New York, his bid was only $3.54 million. Now you will see why he bidded 7 million and now in New York, he only bidded 3.54. The answer is very simple and straightforward. It's improved knowledge about the quality of the diamond. Which I make this point to show you that it's not the carat that determines the value. It's more, the most important characteristic is the color and the clarity. Given the fact that there was no way the price went, the likelihood of the price ever going above 6.536 was very low. And the cutting and polishing option was going to push that value determination so far down the road, we had no option but to accept the 6.536 as the best possible price we could ever get for this piece of diamond.
This couple they now not say alone commercial bank according to Sawunde. But one big question we want go one for ask. Now how they get for shape this couple and almost Pastor Momo go get. As Sawunde they make them clear say the couple now government get them and plenty people go they wonder why.
It will interest you to know that Pastor Momo did not have an artisanal diamond mining license. They applied for one and that process was ongoing and they went and mined. I would say 90-95% possibly of artisanal miners are operating illegally. And that is what we are trying to address as an agency. So technically, he did not own the diamond. The diamond belongs to the government of Sierra Leone. But the Mines and Minerals Act of 2009 has a provision there that says if you find the diamond, you bring it to the attention of the government, even if you don't have a license, you are entitled to 40% of the proceeds. So that is what Pastor Omo has been. And he has signed an undertaking to that effect. It's on my file in the office.
All this discussion be been at the weekly press conference where the Minister of Information can make every Thursday. But for the first time, Pastor Momo not be there part of this meeting. Where we make journalists then be asked Sawunde, why make Pastor Momo not be there part of this meeting?
Pastor Momo is not here because this is a government briefing. I'm just trying to explain to the public the role of the government. And in fact, I called Pastor Momo yesterday to the office to inform him about the good news about the receipt of the money. You know, and he said he's waiting for Chief Saki that he has been working with to come. He's okay with, he knows about it.
Inside in your talk, the Deputy Minister of Information say the government don't put much effort for CCD Diamond get transparency in the way they sell them. And say this will make plenty people not afraid for inform the government if they find big diamond.
We are able to sell a diamond in a very transparent manner, and that will in the long run help to minimize incidents of illegal mining, and it will also minimize incidents of smuggling of diamonds outside this country. Because once the people have confidence that the government can facilitate the sale in a very transparent manner, we are certain that whosoever discovers a diamond in this country will feel very much confident to inform government and to allow government to take the lead in the process.
Sawundi end up say the government go get for engage with all others involved by the money before all man gets in share. For Radio Democracy, Mina Waniga Ojade report.